Hi, it's Marco Van Basten. Welcome to Van Basten's UK Tube. Today we're going to be looking at this, which is the Lavatube V4. I received this free of charge for the purposes of making this review from www.safercigs.co.uk. So thank you very much indeed, Daz. We're going to have a little look in close-up at the various features, and then we'll come back and we'll see how it vapes. So here we are with our box with the Lavatube V4. You see on the side it says Lambo 4.0, and on the end of the box it shows you whether or not it's an 18650 or an 18350 model with a little tick in the box. Inside the box you get a little plastic tray. This is normally covered in tissue paper for safe travel. I've taken that off, so we'll just take that out, and there we have our Lavatube V4. Get it into the right shot, it'll be okay. There we are. It's actually really heavy compared to the original Lavatube, which is so light. This is really heavy. It's kind of Provari heavy, if you like. Let's put a battery in and see how we go. What you can't use are the type like this with the little protruding nipple, because they're just too long. So forget about those. I'm going to be using this one. This is a Panasonic 18650. And that fits quite nicely. And so does the IMR. I know Daz has got batteries on site as well. So have a look there. This kit came without batteries. You can just buy the body only, or you can little kit. We'll talk about that in the wider shot. So as usual with the Lavatubes, you've got basically four buttons. You've got your power on button, you've got your voltage plus and minus buttons, and you've got the fire button. The voltage will always start either where it left off when you change the battery, or where it was when you turned the unit off. You can change that by going up and down with your plus and minus buttons. If you hold the plus and minus buttons together 4 or 5 seconds, that then locks the voltage to that voltage until you press the two buttons together again, and then that unlocks the facility to change. And of course you can go all the way down and up as you see fit. So currently at 4.6. The added function on the version 4 is you press the fire button 5 times, it will tell you the ohms of the device fitted to the top. You'll also notice on the top that center pin has got a screw slot in it, so you can make it higher and lower if you need to. And of course the top is skirted, so it will fit the clearomizers. So we'll just put one of those on. As you can see, no problem at all, and it looks rather nice. And we can see that the original Lavatube comes in at just about 12.5 centimeters, with the Lavatube V4 coming in just over 13 centimeters. And now back to me.
And welcome back. So we have had a look in detail at the Lavatube V4, which again I received free of charge from www.safercigs.co.uk for the purposes of making this review. What I have on it at the moment is a V3 rebuildable atomizer, which I purchased from vapingthings.com a while ago. It's got about a 2.8 ohm coil that I've put on there, and it's probably about 10 days, 2 weeks old, this coil. As I mentioned in the VT you've just seen, if you depress the fire button 5 times, you get the ohmage. And this is showing me a current ohmage of 2.6 ohms, current resistance of 2.6 ohms, which is in the ballpark for this particular coil. What I will say is that as your coil wears out, or as it gets a bit cruddy with juice, the resistance will change. So don't expect this to always match this
every single time, because it won't be the case. It won't give you the same resistance for the entire life of the coil. It does wear down as you're using it, because it's heating up and cooling down quite a lot. So it will make a difference. What I'm using vape-wise is some Decang Crystal Menthol, which I received free of charge from Total E-Liquid. And I've been vaping this for a couple of weeks, and I've been using the Lavatube for a couple of weeks just to get a good comparison. And I'll just put a few drops in. You need to be careful not to overfill these, because it does come out of the air hole on the side. And that's what you need to be careful when you're using these ones, these attis, is to make sure that the air hole is at the top and not at the bottom. Because if you've got it at an angle like this, then the juice drips out onto your shirt or your trousers or whatever, which is no good. You don't want to waste juice, do you? I've got this set currently at 4.2 volts, which is about right for this particular setup that I've got. And you can see you get a decent amount of vapour. It's not always about the vapour, it's about the flavour, really. And this particular atomizer that I've got with the coil set up the way I have, using 0.212 nichrome and silica wick, is working really well. And it looks really nice on the chrome lava tube. What I have to say is that because it's chrome, it's an absolute fingerprint magnet. Every time you pick it up and put it down, it's covered in fingerprints. So if you want to keep it shiny, a little microfiber cloth from the pound shop is always a good buy. Keep it in your pocket. Like I said, in the other VT, the two buttons, plus and minus, will take your voltage down in 0.1 of a volt increment. If you hold both of them in together, just as other versions of the lava tube, it will lock the voltage until you depress both again, between 3 and 5 seconds, and it will unlock it. The power button as normal, 5 seconds on, 5 seconds off. And it will remember the voltage that you have it set at when you turn it off and when you turn it back on again, but not when you change the battery. Daz does have this as a body only, and that's coming in at £44. And he does, I'm just looking on my screen, he does a kit with a charger and a battery for £56. So it's a pretty damn good deal. What do I think of it? I think it's cracking. Weight wise, oh my God, the original lava tube with no battery and nothing on the end comes in at about 48 grams. This weighs in at 127.7 grams without a battery and without anything on the top. So it's a lot weightier, and you can feel it. You can feel the weight, and you can feel the build quality, because I think it's a cracking build quality. I've been using it for nearly 3 weeks now to give it a really good going over. And the little laser etched writing on the side's not wearing off. The only thing that it does is obviously pick up the odd scratch, and it will pick up fingerprints because it's a nice shiny mod. But would I buy one is the question, and the answer to that is yes, I would. Excuse me, if I hadn't had this for free, I would have definitely bought one for £44. I like lava tubes. I've still got my original one that I bought back in February. It's still going strong. I've dropped it, I've stood on it, I've done all sorts of things with it, and it works every time. Occasionally the top section comes a bit loose and I have to push it down, and I did lose the bottom section at one point when I was out in town, which came off, but somebody very kindly sent me one from UK Forum. But it has as well a vent hole for the battery in case of any issues. Obviously if you're using a protected battery, that helps as well. So let's go into the juice a little bit. This is the Decang Crystal Menthol juice. It's mainly PG, which I don't normally vape on. I prefer more of VG than PG, but it's a really nice juice. Menthol wise, it's not one of those types of menthol that once you inhale rips into your back of your throat and pulls out your nose through your mouth, if you know what I mean. It's not really harsh. There's a slight tobacconess to it on the inhale, and you can feel the menthol build in your mouth. And then as you exhale, you get almost like a sweet menthol flavour as opposed to a harsh menthol flavour. I really like it. I'd say it's more pepperminty than spearminty. So I wouldn't say it's like, you know, Polos or Treble Mints or something like that. It's a bit more pepperminty than spearmint. But it's, I've got this with me. Keep wiping it down afterwards. But it's a really nice vape. Yeah, nice taste. What I will say very quickly on the juice is when you buy it, you need to snip the top of the filler out, snip it off because it comes sealed. It is a childproof cap. What Paul actually does when he sends out your juice from Total E-Liquid is he sends you out a free syringe, which is quite nice. This is a 5mm and it comes with a blunt needle cap as well. But having said that, the needle cap does not fit in the filler of the bottle, the Kang bottles. So you've either got to snip it off completely, make a bigger hole, or just pop the cap completely and use that. For dripping, that's fine. It's a nice drip. It's not too fast because the hole is not too big. So if you can use it for dripping, fine. If you're going to want to fill a carto, then you might want to make a little hole, fill it with your syringe, and then do that. But it's a nice touch though to get that sent out in your little jiffy bag. So that was the Decang Crystal Menthol from Total E-Liquid, which I received free of charge. And like I said, I like the taste. If it was VG, I'd like it even more because PG does give me a bit of a sore throat. So I don't tend to vape as much PG as I do VG. But flavour wise, really, really nice. I like it a lot. So to sum up then, I must just say actually, the V3 rebuildable, got my cloth out, the V3 rebuildable, I purchased myself from Vaping Things some time ago, and I really like it. Although it's chrome plated, and that will wear out, for, you know, I think it's $11.99 for the unit, and then I paid an extra £4.50, I think, for the tip, because I quite liked it. But it looks proper nice on the Lavatube. The Lavatube V4, which I got from SaferSigs, www.safersigs.co.uk. This has been Marco Van Basten. You'll find me as normal at ukvapors.org. You'll find all the videos at my YouTube channel, which is The Van Bastens UK. And on Tuesday nights at 9 p.m, you can see me on my Vapor Trails TV show, which is called Vapor Scene. And that goes out every Tuesday at 9 p.m. And you can catch up on old shows using the V Player at www.vaportrails.tv. You can also catch us on YouTube and on Blip and on Livestream. So there's plenty of ways to watch Vapor Trails TV, and there's also plenty of shows. So come and have a look at us and see what you think. So this has been Marco Van Basten. I will see you next time. Hope to see you watching Vapor Scene and the other shows at VTTV. Until the next time, happy vaping. Peace out. Wow.